The new book, Thrawn Ascendancy, Lesser Evil, introduced a new superweapon to the galaxy, something the Chiss call Starflash. We've known for some time that the Chiss homeworld, Chilla, experienced some disaster long ago that left its surface frozen, forcing its citizens to live underground. It turns out Starflash was responsible. 5,000 years before the Clone Wars, the Chiss traveled out of the unknown regions into what they call Lesser Space, but what we would know as Old Republic Space. Hoping to exchange knowledge and technological advancements, the explorers traded with many species and would then bring those new artifacts back to the Ascendancy. One of those items was Starflash, so it wasn't made by the Chiss, and in fact we have no idea who or what created it, but we do know how it works and what it does. Hundreds of years after obtaining Starflash, the Chiss Ascendancy found itself under attack. Chilla soon became the only planet in their territory that wasn't completely overrun. The attackers gathered their full strength there to wipe out the Chiss once and for all. With their people facing total annihilation, Chiss leadership turned to Starflash. It was a single-use weapon that required 20 operators to give their lives for its activation. 20 members of Thrawn's family, the Myth, volunteered. Starflash sent a hyperspeed wave of energy into a star, which would send an exponentially more powerful burst back at the weapon, destroying anything and everything unfortunate enough to be nearby. The Chiss sent Starflash out into the middle of the enemy fleet, where it was triggered. The attackers were destroyed and Chilla was saved, but not without consequence. The energy Starflash took from Chilla's sun caused it to cool, forever changing the planet's surface. For their sacrifice, the Myth family was promoted into the ranks of the Chiss ruling families and were given the emblem of a blazing sun. Now I'm going to get into some more spoilery plot details from Lesser Evil, so if you're still reading the book, this is your warning. Thrawn learns that while Starflash was a single-use weapon, more than one was initially built. The Chiss brought two of them back from Lesser Space, and the second was kept locked away for nearly 5 millennia after the first was activated. At one point, we are led to believe that Thrawn plans to use it to save the Chiss once again, but he develops a different plan instead. However, he does gravely say that he would have used Starflash if he felt it was the best course of action. I mention that to say that the Chiss still have a superweapon in their arsenal. With Grand Admiral Thrawn set to make his live-action debut on Disney+, could he bring Starflash along with him? I doubt it. I think the superweapon in this book was a story device meant to be a looming threat and moral debate. Although Thrawn refuses its use this time, we also see that he is not opposed to activating a weapon like it if he feels the ends justify the means. As someone who feels Thrawn can be inconsistent in the books versus his on-screen appearances, I think acknowledging that was a step in the right direction. From what I can tell, Timothy Zahn doesn't know what's in store for Thrawn in live action. Maybe he's just playing coy about what he knows, but I doubt it. So I don't think Zahn was writing anything to suggest what's to come for Thrawn's future outside of the Chiss Ascendancy. I think Starflash will likely remain an artifact of the books, and I think that's the right way to go. Thrawn as a villain is threatening enough. It's so much more fun seeing him outwit and outplay the heroes in the books. I wouldn't want him to be reduced to yet another Star Wars antagonist with a superweapon. If you're interested in reading Thrawn Ascendancy Lesser Evil for yourself, you can pick it up for free on Audible by clicking on the link in the description or by going to www.audibletrial.com/StarWarsExplained. The audiobook is out right now, and the production value on all the Star Wars audiobooks is very high with sound effects and music. It's like listening to a movie. Signing up for an Audible trial will get you a credit for one free audiobook, and you can use it on Lesser Evil or just about any Star Wars book you can think of. Or get anything you want. The point is, you get a free book, and you'll be supporting the channel when you do. But that's it for today. If you haven't already, please like this video, subscribe to the channel, follow us on TikTok, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, and consider checking out our Patreon page. As always, thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you.